So, as a programmer, everything you choose to spend time on is kind of a bet on your future, because the ramp of skills that you acquire is kind of exponential. So you kind of learn a couple of things and then you can write your first program. Maybe it's a couple of HTML tags, something like that. But as you go along your career, those skills compound, and now you don't just know a couple of HTML tags. Maybe you know like HTML, CSS, and maybe a little bit of JavaScript. Those skills then compound into more and more and more and more. And you get this kind of like exponential curve where, like, before you were doing like a single HTML file, no styling, whatever. And now you're building full on web applications with authentication that can support multi-user and whatever, whatever, right? So what you spend time on really matters. And this is what I'm choosing to spend time on in 2023. The first thing I've got here, of course, which may not be surprising to any of you that are following the channel or have been for the last year, is Rust. And that's because Rust can kind of do everything I need it to do. And it also opens up some avenues that I am less familiar with. So things like embedded programming. So in my consulting or freelancing career, I've usually kept two languages kind of in a production ready state. So like if I needed to do some work, I could do a contract with, say, like some backend language and some front end language, roughly speaking. Those distinctions, of course, are not super accurate these days. But if I consider Rust to be that sort of high performance backend language, and I consider JavaScript to be the UI-based front end, whatever else I need language, then Rust is a really good fit because it can cover such an absolutely wide range of programs that I may choose to want to get into. It can do APIs, it can do WASM, it can do embedded programming, operating system development. It can do CLI applications and really anything I need it to do. So no surprise, Rust is going to be my language of choice coming into this year. And I'm not really looking for other languages right now, but I'm feeling like I need a little bit of a perk up. So let's go do that. Now, the second thing that I think I'm really going to focus on in 2023 is WASM. So that may seem obvious with the Rust connotations. I think this actually has water in it, but with some recent work that I've done, I think that WASM is a little bit closer than it used to being actually usable. And since Rust is so good at compiling to WASM, it feels like I should generate a depth of expertise in this area. I think I knocked the beans around a little bit. Now that, plus I've actually done a little bit of experimentation recently, and it makes me feel like WASM is an actual real choice now for building web UIs, which is really interesting because it really, in my opinion, hasn't been over the last, say, 5 years. That video, however, is taking a long time, so get ready for that one later. I think we're just about done here. It's still gonna be pretty hot. It's good though, it's good, it's a blonde. You know, I got into blondes recently, and yeah, it's good, it's good. So what else do we have here? I have covered Rust. We've covered WASM. I'm also going to commit to Bevy and WGPU. And this is because I think I've mentioned it on the channel before, but I have a long-term goal to ship a game on the Switch. And while that may never happen, because by the time I get to that point, the Switch may not be a console anymore, I have some concrete goals this year to ship games on Steam as steps towards that goal. So while it may seem odd that I'm choosing Bevy for a goal to ship on Switch when really, there's not that many people targeting Switch with Rust, and especially with Bevy at the moment, I think that settling in with Bevy for a long term, so betting on Bevy for about 5 years, 10 years, is the choice that I'm making here. And Bevy can obviously ship games to Steam already, so I'm not too worried about it. And I know that people already have Rust running on Switch, so we'll find out when I get there anyway. But for me, the part of Bevy that I find the most interesting is probably the GPU programming with shaders and making really neat visuals. So I want to make sure that I ship games on Steam this year, that I do so in a way that completes. So like whenever I build a game on the channel, I want to also finish it off by shipping it and making it available for you to actually play, because that would be really cool. And we'll see where that goes. So with Rust and WASM and Bevy and WGPU out of the way, the last one that I'm going to focus on this year is embedded programming. Now, I've already gotten started with this with the Microbit V2, which is on the channel as a video if you want to go watch that. And I want to continue with that with more things that are ready and working that other people have already made work. Things like displaying graphics to a screen. Got an Inky frame right here that I want to do that with at some point. That one of my friends, Derek, has, I believe, already got working. Unless they haven't, and I'm mistaken. But software gives you this incredible ability to kind of just create things out of your own mind. And Rust gives me this incredible ability to feel empowered enough to go take my software skills and apply them on physical hardware. So it would be really cool to extend the amount of time that I've spent writing software and start making some little physical products, some of which are just laying here around my desk, right? Could I build my own Stream Deck, you know? So we're gonna start off with some stuff that's already been established. I'm gonna move into maybe some things that's a little bit less established, and then hopefully one day get to the point where I am picking my own components and building my own little gadgets to just throw around. But that's it. These are the four things that I'm focusing on for 2023 in terms of technology. What are you digging into this year? What are you betting on for yourself over the next, say, 365 days? Let me know in the comments. And if you liked the video, like the video, and I will catch you tomorrow in the next one. Have a great day.